Touchdown. He reached forward with the football and got it into the end zone. The officials hesitated, Charlie, but then they indicated touchdown.
Well, I think what they did, this is a great throw and catch right here, and this is the underneath pattern that LSU has been hurting Kentucky with. They bring Joe back underneath right over the middle. He catches it. Let's see if he does in actuality get it across. Knees down at the 2.5-yard line. That should not have been a touchdown, Rob, as you could well see. However, Kentucky will take it. I don't blame them. Big touchdown.
Well, it's been Randy Jenkins to Joe Phillips here in the second half. A 6-yard touchdown pass in the third quarter, which put the Wildcats on top, 14-10. Now it's 20-10 Kentucky. Chris Caudell comes on to attempt the extra point, and he has made it 21-10. We've got just over 11 minutes left to go, and we've got a timeout on the field with the score, Kentucky 21, LSU 10.
Can Stanley Schober name all of First Security's locations in one breath?
Oh, then I see the main office, airport, always Mountain Park, Garden Side, Northland, Southland, Eastland, Richland, Roan, Peckham. Do I see downtown, Case Creek, Chevy, Chase, and University? There's Manowar, Stonewall, and that's all.
Nice going, Stanley. And First Security has more locations than any other bank in Central Kentucky. Now that's talking convenience. First Security, when you need more from a bank.
That's easy for you to say.
Kentucky against LSU, both of these teams trying to win their first conference game of the season. And right now the Wildcats are in the driver's seat, Charlie. They lead it 21-10 with 11 minutes left to go.
Rob, this is going to be the longest 11 minutes and 5 seconds that Jerry Claiborne and his coaching staff have spent in a long time, especially if this LSU football team starts to move the ball any at all. This crowd will start going crazy.
There's the Kentucky drive, 69 yards, 8 plays. Kentucky now with an 11-point lead. And the kick taken by Norman Jefferson a couple of yards deep. Jefferson comes up to the 20-yard line, and that's all. Russell Hairston there on the tackle. And Steve Mazza, number 38. Tigers will put it in play, first and 10, and they will start from their own 22. Well, I'd like to remind you, the Jerry Claiborne Show, we will have highlights of tonight's game tomorrow at noon, right here on Channel 27. Join Coach Claiborne, Charlie McCullers, and me. We'll review it for you on the Jerry Claiborne Show. First and 10 LSU from the 22. Wickersham still the quarterback. And this is Dalton Hilliard. It's a good haul. Comes up across the 25-yard line. Picks up about 4 yards. In there to knock him down, number 70, Keith Martin.
Keith Martin played an outstanding game tonight. With his strength, he's able to sit inside and play with these big offensive linemen. Kentucky will be content to let them gain 3 or 4 yards of play, make them go the long way and burn that clock, Rob.
From the 25, let's call it second down, 7 yards to go. Wickersham to throw. Eric Martin breaks free at the 45 and comes across midfield and is finally hauled down by Stacy Burrell. But LSU moves into Kentucky territory.
Well, that's the one thing that Kentucky did not want to happen, was to give them a big play and give this crowd a chance to get pumped up, and here it goes. And this is the pass he tried to hit earlier, and the linebacker was underneath. This time the linebacker was out of position, and he just drills the ball into Martin. A missed tackle by Kerry Baird. Right there. Martin just doesn't like to get pulled down, does he? He doesn't like to be tackled.
Eric Martin out of Van Fleck, Texas. First and 10 now, LSU at the Kentucky 48. Wickersham pumping. Frank Hare puts him down at about the line of scrimmage. As Wickersham tried to wiggle out of it, Frank Hare was right there.
Well, Rob, tomorrow when the coaching staff gets to looking at that film, they're going to be sick, because Jeff Wickersham is trying to go to his outside receivers deep every time. Watching pump here. Still wanting to go deep. He has two men wide open over the middle. We can't see them from this angle, but his tight end and his running back both were wide open over the middle, no one around them.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Still from the Kentucky 48-yard line. Caught by Eric Martin at the 30. Kerry Baird hauled him out of bounds, and Farrell Sheridan hit the text on the Kentucky sideline. He's all right.
It gets dangerous over there, but there was double coverage on Martin that time. What, he has a man deep on him, a man short and inside, and Wickersham drills the ball in there, and he makes the catch, and they're an outstanding duo.
18-yard pass play from Jeff Wickersham to Eric Martin. First and 10 LSU at the Kentucky 30. 9 minutes and 33 seconds left to go in the game. Kentucky leading LSU 21-10 here at Tiger Stadium. But the Tigers are marching. Wickersham handing it off on the draw. That's Gene Lang, the fullback, and Keith Martin. Hustles over to haul him down from behind, but not before Lang picks up about 7 yards.
Well, they are moving the football real well right now. They're mixing up their plays between the draw, between the run. Do we have a flag on the play?
No, I did not see it go down, but...
It's against Kentucky. I'm not sure what the call is.
Could be a holding call against the Wildcats, Charlie. Let's see what the Markoff is. It is a holding call. There's the preliminary signal.
They must have been holding one of the receivers outside. I did not see where the flag was thrown.
They mark it off inside the 15, down to the 13-yard line, holding against Kentucky. And a very costly penalty.
Well, Kentucky has to slow down now. They need to get their poise back on defense. It's the first drive that LSU's made on them this half. They need to just tighten their chin strap a little bit, make it tough on LSU. Don't do anything crazy.
It is first and 10 from the Kentucky 13. Dalton Hilliard nowhere to run. Jeff Smith was right there to stop him, number 79. Big man out of Springfield, Kentucky.
Well, and the Navy's are restless with that call. They want to see the ball in the air.
We've not heard too many boos here tonight, but LSU has had a tough second half.
Yes, they have. This is the first sustained drive they've had, and it's been on two big pass plays, basically a short run and a penalty.
Send Martin to the left, Fontenot to the right. Second down, 10 yards to go from the 13. Wickersham. Well, he got away from Keith Martin, but he won't get away from Jeff Smith as he sacks back at the 24-yard line.
Well, an outstanding coverage in that defensive secondary. They just rushed the four big men again, and they were locked in two deep, man for man. Did a great job of taking away his receivers. Here he is right here. Watch Keith Martin put the pressure on, misses him right there, and here comes big Jeff Smith to wrap him up. Amerson wanting to get in there and get a little bit of that. They could get excited. Big, crucial play, the next two plays, this one especially.
Loss is back to the 22, a loss of 9. So it's third down and long yardage. Third and 19. And the ball is tipped away by Brian Williams. The penalty marker goes down. Pass was intended for Eric Martin.
That is another ridiculous call. No way the man knew that the ball had been tipped. Once the ball is tipped, there cannot be any type of pass interference. He might have called unnecessary roughness, but again, Carmichael Caldwell had no way of knowing the ball had been tipped and that the receiver did not have a chance. Watch this. It gets tipped right here.
There's Brian Williams.
No way Carmichael Caldwell can pull off, but the forearm might be what was called. If that's what was called, it was the correct call.
Now here comes the Markoff against Kentucky, and this is another very, very costly penalty. We still got 7 minutes and 59 seconds to play in this game.
But this year, instead of it being a first down right there, it's going to be a penalty of half the distance to the goal line.
Personal foul against the Wildcats moves it down to the 11-yard line, Charlie. And it's going to be third down now, and what, about 8 yards to go, third down and 7?
And they can make a first down about the 3.5-yard line.
Well, it's third down and 7. Well, Kentucky moved in front with just over 11 minutes to go in this game. The Wildcats went in front 21-10.
It is fourth down.
It is fourth down.
Yes, I'll tell you what that was. That was called after the play, and that's the reason they could call it. It could not have been pass interference. It was unnecessary roughness, and they are going for the field goal, and the LSU fans are uptight. Watch it fake.
Well, that was a time that the scoreboard was right and the yard marker was wrong. I was watching the yard marker. Juan Betanzos to kick it off the 17-yard line, a 27-yard attempt. And it is perfect. Juan Betanzos booms it through. The LSU fans do not like it one bit. And the Tigers draw back to within 8 points. We got a timeout on the field with a score. Kentucky 21, LSU 13.
Do it yourself the American way with all-American tools at all-American prices at Harbor Freight's Tool Warehouse. The Black & Decker Power Saber Saw, a must for every all-American workshop, is all-American priced at a low $8.97. Look at this Stanley magnetic screwdriver with five interchangeable bits that store in the handle. Truly an all-American tool, and they're only $4.95 while they last. Harbor Freight has bought the remaining stock of Campbell Hospital's 3-horsepower, 2-cycle air compressors, and you save. They're only $319 while they last. All-American tools, all-American prices at Harbor Freight's Tool Warehouse, 1387 New Circle Road.
Well, here at Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge, Rob Bromley along with Charlie McCullers, and we've still got a lot of football to play. 7 minutes, 55 seconds. Kentucky's lead sliced to 8 points at 21-13. Rob, on the field goal by Juan Betanzos. And Charlie, you feel as though that was a good decision.
I know it was a good decision. If you look at the scoreboard, it's 21-13. There's an 8-point difference. Instead of taking a chance and still having to have two touchdowns, now he's in a position where he has to have one touchdown and a 2-point conversion, and he has tied the ball game.
Juan Betanzos kept the kick very, very low, and it went out of bounds down around the 1 or 2 yard line, and LSU is going to have to kick all over again.
No, I agree with that decision totally. And who knows, it also puts him in a situation where if he goes for the two and he misses, he just has to get in field goal position, and Betanzos is a good field goal kicker. So he, I think, very definitely made the right decision.
Well, LSU went in front of this game late in the first half, putting together a touchdown drive to take a 10-7 lead. Kentucky then took over in the third and fourth periods. Two touchdown passes. Randy Jenkins hitting Joe Phillips on both of them. The Wildcats led 21-10. LSU has now added a field goal by Juan Betanzos, and it's 21-13. So an 8-point difference with still almost 8 minutes on the clock. Ball moved back to the 35 now, and Betanzos will kick over again. Tony Mays and Mark Logan are back deep to return it. And he squibs it down to the near side of the field. Mays lets it go. Very, very wise decision by Tony Mays. He took a good look at it, let it go out of bounds, and LSU will have to kick now from the 30.
He made my heart come up in my throat because I thought he was going to try to scoop that thing up with one hand and run with it, and that would have been a catastrophe because it was well covered. That Kentucky offense should have some decent field position here, figuring they should get the ball back 25 or 30 yard line. If they can string together some first downs, Rob, they can make it very, very difficult on LSU to make a comeback unless the Kentucky defense were to make a big, big mistake.
Kentucky won on this field back in 1977. And we mentioned that at the start of our telecast, 33-13 over the Tigers. That was the last Kentucky victory over LSU. Charlie, they almost won here in 1979, had a 19-3 lead early in the game. Well, in the third quarter, LSU came back to win 23-19.
Well, I promise you, I did say a few things about the officials that day. They gave them a pass out of bounds. They called a pass interference that wasn't even close. Let's watch the kickoff.
Betanzos hits this one pretty good. It's going to be Logan back around the 10. Comes up over the 30. He's got nothing but running room.
Clip him.
That is George Adams. I beg your pardon, not Mark Logan. We've got a penalty marker down back of the 35-yard line.
Very definitely clip him. I think we'll see it if we have a replay of it.
So George Adams gets a 90-yard run, but we believe this will be called back.
There are two flags on the play.
One is dropped at the 35. And the other one, Charlie, must have just been picked up.
It was either illegal use of the hands, he pushed him in the back. Let's see if we can pick it up. Here's George Adams taking the ball, and you can see from the time he catches the football that the wall opens up, and right along here is where the flag came. They had to call it on. There it is right there. I don't see it.
A little bit hard to see from ground level, but offsetting penalties.
They called holding is what they called. It was not a clip. They must have held him.
Illegal use of the hands. So Kentucky now is going to start from its 30-yard line. First and 10 Wildcats. Randy Jenkins is the quarterback. Looks like Chris Derry and Choo Choo Lee, the running backs, and Randy shouting an audible at the line of scrimmage. This is Lee. Brings it back to the line of scrimmage if he's lucky. Not much running room off the right side.
So now is when Kentucky has to string together some offensive plays, some first downs, control that clock.
Clock running with 7:21 left to go in the football game. As Choo Choo Lee is hit and dropped by, looks like Roland Barbe, the nose guard. Eric Kittock, the left side defensive tackle, was off in there.
Well,
also
there. It was well diagnosed by the defense. Well played.
Second down and 10. Oliver White takes it on the reverse. Gets a couple of yards, but that's all. Barbe was there along with Sean Burks. So it'll be third down coming up and about 9 yards to go. They mark it at the 32. Call it third and 8.
All right, here's the reverse. Oliver White coming around, well read by the defense. Defensive right tackle's out there waiting, cuts it back inside, and just gets all he can back up inside. Big, big play right here, Rob. They need a first down in the worst way, and looks like it's man coverage with a blitz.
Massey out of the left, and Phillips comes out of the right. They hand it off to Lee. Drake Dubrock, the left outside linebacker, hauls him down. Dubrock, a junior from New Orleans. It'll be fourth down and long yardage coming up, and Kentucky will have to kick it away. Well, hang on, we still got a ways to go. Clock running with 6 minutes and 12 seconds left in the game. Kentucky leading LSU 21-13.
The clock's at 21. They should let the play clock click down to at least 5. They snapped it at 15.
Could have used another 10, 12 seconds.
At least.
Calhoun kicks it away. Lifford Hobley takes it in at the 35-yard line. And LSU will have fairly good position with which to work.
Yes, they do, Rob. They have the wind at their back. And the Kentucky defense needs to stop them right here.
I'll tell you, this Kentucky defense, Charlie, was impressive in the third period.
Well, they were. And in the last series, they hit them on a couple of long passes, and then they had the penalties. But they did hold them when it counted to a field goal. This time, they have to keep them out of the end zone.
Martin goes out to the right. Fontenot to the left. First and 10 from the 35. Jeff Smith putting the pressure on Wickersham, and he very, very wisely dumped it off. Dalton Hilliard was over there, but Wickersham threw that one away.
Well, they had 5 receivers out then, and they're getting 1 double team, and they're not double teaming Jeff Smith. They're double teaming Keith Martin that time. Jeff Smith beat his man one-on-one to put the pressure on.
Sophomore quarterback Jeff Wickersham out of Merritt Island, Florida. Had a great high school career there. Was one of the Football News Nifty 50. Second down and 10 yards to go from the 35. Down the middle, Eric Martin into Kentucky territory and down inside the 40-yard line. Russell Hairston was the first man who tripped him up, and then Kerry Barrett came over. Big pass play from Wickersham to Martin.
Well, Martin is a big play man, and I think if you here's Martin right here, watch him at the left split receiver. Works inside to have a zone, work back inside. Kevin McClellan just did miss it. When he's in trouble, he goes to Martin, and Martin has been coming up with a big play every time.
Clock is running with 5 minutes and 26 seconds left to go in the game. Kentucky leading LSU 21-13. First and 10 Tigers from the Kentucky 39. Wickersham trying to run out of the pocket, and there again is Jeff Smith to put him away. Jeff Smith now hobbles off the field. Oh, he has really come back from that foot surgery, Charlie.
Yes, he has, and he's just had an outstanding game tonight. He might just need a breather. It's very, very difficult. It's still, even though it's cool down here, there's still a lot of humidity. I imagine he's tired, and they'll put Frank Hare in there. Frank Hare is also a very good pass rusher.
Well, the loss is back to the 44-yard line. Call it a loss of 5. It's second down and 15. Wickersham. Brian Williams couldn't get him. He got the pass away, and it's incomplete, and I'll tell you, there's nobody over there. The Kentucky sidelines is hollering for a flag.
Well, that's twice. And even if there's a white jersey there, it does not matter. That is 2 times that he has definitely grounded the football, and that is very, I am surprised at the officials. That is ridiculous.
I'll tell you, if anything, that one was more blatant than the other one.
Maybe there's something about the rule that I've lost in the 2 years I've been out of coaching, but I'll guarantee you, Jerry Claiborne is on top of it, and he was irate.
Third down and 15 from the LSU 44. The Kentucky 44, I beg your pardon. Wickersham throwing back to the near side and incomplete. He overthrew Gene Lang. Kevin McClellan on the coverage.
Well, that was excellent coverage by Kevin McClellan. Well, let's see if they go for it right here. It's getting down pretty tight. I would not be surprised to see them go for it on fourth down.
Clock stopped with 4.5 minutes left to go in the game. LSU trailing Kentucky 21-13.
Before he throws the football, this decision I do not agree with. I think he should try to punt it down tight, try to force Kentucky into mistake. I say that whether he makes it or not. I think this is a wrong decision by Jerry Stovall.
Well, Junius Durrell brought the play in from the bench. Fourth down, 15 from the Kentucky 44. Wickersham hits Martin.
Not make the first.
It came up short. Charlie, right at the 30-yard line. Kerry Baird was there to make the hit. And it's going to be about a half yard short of the first down.
Well, let's see what the mark is. I believe they're going to measure. No, they called it Kentucky football. And again, I say that was a mistake because he should have tried to kick the ball out of bounds or dead down inside of the 10. There was plenty of time left. And right here, an excellent play by Kerry Baird. Excellent tackle. He's right on the 30-yard line. He leaves him right there. Good shape.
And I'd say the mark was good, right at the 30. Oh, that was just a half yard short. What a hit by Kerry Baird. 4:16 left to go in the game. Kentucky takes over at its own 30. Jenkins?
No.
Threw it away. Joker Phillips here at the near side. Alex Clark on the coverage for LSU.
Rob, he was wide open. He should have hit that one. He was a little bit late throwing the football. He was wide open, and that was a much needed piece of yardage. They need to get the ball up so they kick the ball dead between the 20, somewhere between the 20, the 10, back down close to goal line and make this LSU team go the long distance.
Charlie, what about throwing on first down there? 4:11.
I have no problem with that. They are not good enough to run the football consistently against this LSU defense.
Second down and 10. There goes George Adams, and that's why. Rydell Malanzon was right there along with Roland Barbe, the nose guard. It'll be a loss of about a yard or two. Clock now goes down to 4 minutes, and we have a timeout called on the field by LSU. So the Tigers want to stop the clock right here. All right, we've got a timeout on the field. 4 minutes exactly left to go. The score, Kentucky 21, LSU 13.
When Valvoline announced its gold medal sale with special prices on Valvoline Motor Oil, we knew it'd be popular, but we didn't know it'd be like this.
I can't believe it's all gone.
Getting a top-quality motor oil that won a gold medal for lubricating excellence at a money-saving offer is too good to pass up.
I can't believe it's all gone.
Better get yours now while you can. Look for Valvoline on sale here during the gold medal sale.
Now available at AutoWise, the Parts Pro, Hex, and Womwell, the Parts House.
Well, the Kentucky Wildcats are just 4 minutes away for winning their first conference game since 1981. We've got 4 minutes to go, Charlie. Kentucky leads LSU 21-13.
Rob, that's 4 hours. I'll promise you on the sideline, that is 4 hours. They have to make a first down. There's plenty of time left in this football game for LSU to win it, and they're hot right now as far as being able to move the football.
Third down, 11 yards to go. George Adams can't get any running room at all. Roland Barbe and Clarence Osborne were there to make the tackle.
Now use all of the 25-second clock, Kentucky. Use every bit of it you can. Don't snap that ball early. All right, here it is right here. They're just not strong enough to run against LSU. They're trying to play it conservative. That's all right. No problem, but we're at 19-18. Don't snap it yet, please.
Still 15 seconds on that clock, and they're watching it closely this time, Charlie. It's down to 10.
I think there's going to be a penalty on Kentucky. I'm not sure. I think there was movement by number 38 in the right guard position. They're not going to call it. Must have been an inadvertent whistle. They restart the clock and click it down. But the field clock is not running, and it should be running. The field clock should be running.
It's at 3:23 right now, and it stopped. Here's the punt by Paul Calhoun. Lifford Hobley back to return it. Kick carries over the LSU 40-yard line and goes out of bounds at around the 36. So LSU does not have bad field position. The Tigers have 3 minutes and 15 seconds. And they trail by 8 points as Jeff Wickersham leads his offensive unit back onto the field.
Well, I think Coach Claiborne's after the man on the clock right now. They did not start the clock after the whistle had blown, and there was at least 10 seconds left that they could have ran off that clock.
Total offense in this game, you can see that LSU has cranked out 273 yards to the Wildcats, 200. First and 10 Tigers from their own 36. Wickersham. Down the middle to tight end Mitch Andrews. John Grimsley and Kevin McClellan right there to make the tackle. Gain is across the 40. They will mark it just shy of the 43. It'll be second down and 4 yards to go coming up. Mitch Andrews, the tight end, sophomore out of Houma, Louisiana. Timeout called by LSU. The Tigers have one timeout left. We've got a break with the score. Kentucky 21, LSU 13.
Lexington Coffee Products needs two more experienced copier sales representatives to sell the two leading copier manufacturers, Minolta and Canon. Expansion into government and major accounts have created these positions with potential earnings of $25,000 to $40,000 per year. Salary, commission, and insurance are all a part of the package at Lexington Coffee Products. If you have enthusiasm and a drive to excel, and you are a copier salesman, then call Ron Gayhart at 276-3563.
Back in Baton Rouge, Rob Bromley along with Charlie McCullers, and we've got 3 minutes and 2 seconds left to go. Kentucky leading LSU 21-13. The Tigers have the football. They've got it at their own 42-yard line. It's second down and 4 yards to go. LSU would need a touchdown, a two-point conversion to tie this game.
Well, defensively right now, they need to keep them in bounds. Don't let them stop the clock by getting out of bounds. Make them work inside the hash mark.
Wickersham dumps it off to Dalton Hilliard, and Glenn Emerson comes diving through to knock down Dalton Hilliard back at the 35-yard line. Big play by Glenn Emerson.
Well, and Cam Jacobs almost got a penalty that time. That was very, very careless. Watch this right here. Big play by Glenn Emerson. He was looking for the screen. We're back to live.
It is third down and 11. Wickersham under a rush. And is hit just as he delivers the pass. Frank Hare was the man who was all over Jeff Wickersham. Look at Frank Hare and Kevin McClellan. Some of the Tiger fans, Charlie, have started to head for the exits. We've still got 2.5 minutes left to play.
Well, Kentucky is now within striking distance. They can win this ball game. There's one timeout left. They just need to make one first down, and they can run it out clock. But they need to make sure they use 22, 23, 24 seconds every time that clock rolls.
Jerry Stovall has elected to punt it away. Clay Parker, the barefooted kicker out of the field, standing at his own 21. Brian Williams has dropped back around his own 30. No rush at all. And Parker gets away a long spiraling kick. It hits at the 15, and it's a dandy as LSU downs it down around the 5-yard line. Hustling down there to get it for the Tigers was Steve Rehage. So Kentucky backed up against its old goal line. 2 minutes, 21 seconds left to go in the game, and the Wildcats leading by 8 points. And everybody now has got to hang on to that football, get a good tight grip.
That's the one thing you tell your offensive line and you tell your backs, the offensive lineman, don't let anyone penetrate to get around the handoff. The offensive back, cover that ball up with both hands. Whatever you do, don't let them strip it away. LSU has one timeout.
First and 10 Wildcats from their own 7. Handoff comes to George Adams, takes it off the left side. Comes up to the 10-yard line. In there on the tackle for LSU, looked like number 48 came up there, John Fritchie, the linebacker. Clock running. 2:01, 2 minutes left to go in the game, and now we go under 2 minutes. Kentucky with an 8-point lead. There's the story, 21-13 Wildcats. Kentucky has not won a Southeastern Conference game since that victory at Commonwealth Stadium over Tennessee. Fran Kersey's final game. Good running room for George Adams as he takes it across the 15.
And it's a first down, I believe, Rob.
He got it up to the 17. Let's wait and see where they mark it. Well, there have been some Wildcat fans who have made the trip down here to Baton Rouge. And, Charlie, I think they've liked what they've seen so far. We've still got a minute 39 to go. It's a Kentucky first down.
Well, if mathematically, even though they use their timeout, if Kentucky will maintain and use their 25 seconds, they should be able to run this clock down to absolutely nothing and win this football game.
Wildcats and double wide receivers out of the left, and they elect to keep it right on the ground. Choo-Choo Lee brings it up to the 25. That's a run of about 7 yards.
Rob, I've watched LSU and coached against LSU a long time, and normally when LSU, late in the game, gets you backed up with your back to the goal line like that, you can't make an inch. This football team has quit.
LSU has one timeout left. One timeout left. We go under 1 minute. 55 seconds left to go, and Kentucky should have this one in the bag, leading it 21-13. 49 seconds. 48. Counting down now. It's second down and three for the Wildcats. They're from the 24. Choo-Choo Lee breaks outside. Holds onto the ball, comes across the 30-yard line. He's got another first down. Charlie, I think Kentucky's won it. 37 seconds left to go.
Well, LSU is expending their final timeout.
All right, let's take a break. We'll be back in a moment. Kentucky leading LSU here in the final minute, 21-13. We'll be right back.
Save money. Tower and Saunders Auto Care Centers will save you money by offering these great discount values now through Friday, October 21st. Savings on the complete line of Monroe shock absorbers. Front end alignment, $988. Tune-ups from $27. Radiator flush, $18.95. Save money on Firestone 721 radials, Michelin, and General Tires. See the Tower and Saunders ad in this Sunday's Herald Leader. America rides on Monroe shock absorbers, and at Tower and Saunders, you get a 50% savings on the second shock absorber now through Friday.
Kentucky just 37 seconds away from winning its first Southeastern Conference game since 1981. There is a dejected Jerry Stovall here at the near side of the field. LSU fans have headed for the exits. There is a large group of Kentucky fans here that is celebrating. The Wildcats lead it 21-13. And Charlie, what a great night this has been for Jerry Claiborne and his staff.
Well, to come into Tiger Stadium and win with any kind of football team is great, but this is not an extremely strong football team. They just have to have a lot of desire, a lot of determination, and Randy Jenkins falling on the football. That is the greatest offense in the world. That's called kill the clock, save the game, whatever you want to call it, but he falls down and just runs out that clock, and it should be just all over right now.
Well, let's see. I don't believe we'll see another play.
I don't think so.
LSU has no more timeouts. The clock is down to 14 seconds, and the Wildcats are going to stand around, enjoy it, and let the clock run out. Look at the Kentucky sideline. Bill Ransell there, number 9. Scott Schroeder there, number 42. They are whooping it up along the sidelines as Kentucky has won it. It is all over. The final score here at Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge. Kentucky 21, LSU 13. Stay with us. We'll be right back.